Welcome back to my channel. Finally came. It was supposed to come last Thursday. My new record. Doing a little bit of an unboxing. So yeah, let's get into it. So I got the CD and the record for this. Cradle of Filth. Existence is futile. I will be listening to this and making a first impression sort of review. Hopefully by the time I get this one up, I'll actually have two up already with this whole setup. I have to just record. I actually have to still listen to the Therapy album at this point in time, but yeah, I've been kind of gaming a lot, so there it is, and it's glory. There's the records, blah blah blah. Looking on the sleeves. There are the lyrics. Has I think the bonus tracks, the CD it doesn't, because I would have gonna spend that much more for the limited edition CD since I got the record, and the record is more than enough in my opinion. But yeah, cool cover art. I think I always liked the cover. The cover has always been awesome. Alright, and now this is like a special edition record. So let's take a look, shall we? Look at that. That's gonna look sick spinning on that record player. Like each of the center pieces. It's a little different part of the cover. To my music reviews coming up here at some point, and oh man, it's got a stick. What the fuck? Happy Halloween, everyone. I know that I said after the last review video that I was going to do the Thurfing album next, but because it's Halloween,
Because I've been waiting all year for this Cradle of Filth album, I decided we're going to do the Cradle of Filth album first. Because, yeah, I said so. Haha. the Theorfing album will come hopefully soon. Again, I have a script on my computer, so if you see me kind of glancing over there, that's why. I didn't really follow it word for word last time. I'm probably not going to follow it word for word this time. However, it'll at least kind of help me keep my thoughts in check so I don't go rambling on and on and on about something inconsequential. Which I'm kind of doing now because I did not actually write this part of the script. So, this is the review for Cradle of Filth's newest album, Existence is Futile. Just released on October 22nd of 2021. Recorded during the Great Plague of 2020. That's what it says on the back of the record. I didn't even make that up. I just thought that was funny as hell, so I threw that in there. And yeah, let's get into it. You can actually kind of see more of where my eyes are. Okay, sorry. So yeah, I just finished listening to it for the first time. Very good album. Very good album. And yeah, so let's get into it. So the album starts with, as most Cradle of Filth albums start off with, a instrumental. This one for this album is called The Fate of the World on Our Shoulders. It's very short. It's very, yeah, I mean, very kind of atmospheric, as they always seem to be. But nothing really is much to talk about with that. But it does end up going into the first actual lyric song, whatever you want to call it, with Existential Terror. Very solid start to the album. Very much in line with Cryptoriana, The Seductiveness of Decay, and Hammer of the Witches. Didn't really grip me like Cryptoriana did at the beginning of that. I don't know. But yeah, like, very, very good song. Very good album overall. This is going to kind of be a little bit of a rambly thing. I'm not, especially for a band that I've listened to for so long, I'm not really good at not being biased and not really, like, you know, I don't know. It's hard for me to kind of describe songs. Like, it's very, the whole album was very bombastic. You know, Necromantic Fantasies, which is the third song, is, you know, just more of the same. It turned out to be their second single, which, there's a YouTube video of their music video. I've not seen any of their music video, either music video for this album yet, because I wanted to kind of go into this album blind, give it like a you know, good real first listen to. You know, there are three instrumentals, pretty much the first song of the first three sides of the LPs are all instrumentals. With, you know, The Fate of the World on Our Shoulders, Here Comes a Candle, Infernal Lullaby, which we'll get into in a second, and Ashen Mortality. So yeah, and then the fourth song, the final song on the first side, is Crawling King Chaos, which was the first single. Very good start to the album overall. Very, like I said, very much in the line of their last two. I like the direction that Cradle of Filth has been going in the last few records now. The second side starts with Here Comes a Candle, Infernal Lullaby. It's a very piano-heavy instrumental track, which kind of sounds very reminiscent to, like, those old-timey, like, Victorian, like, music boxes, you know. Which I dug. I thought that was a really cool way of doing it. And it's kind of like the sound that Cradle always seems to have, especially like with Cryptoriana is kind of got that almost like Victorian-esque sort of feel to it. Look at the face paint done by a, well, yeah, Ash, who is like my only subscriber right now at the time of this. I think I didn't check today, but I highly doubt anybody else. And somebody else has awesome, great, thank you. But yeah, Black smoke curling from the lips of war is, I believe, the first song that includes Annabelle Erotny, the new female vocalist and keyboardist for the band. I may have missed something from the first side. I don't recall hearing anything like any like lyrics from her, but if I did, I do apologize. I was trying to write this kind of first impression review script as I was listening to it, and kind of like, so there's a few little spots here and there where I maybe didn't quite catch everything, but she definitely ranks up there with the female vocalists, obviously. Like Nymphetamine had what the hell's her name now? The old vocalist for Leaves' Eyes, and I mean she's just a great vocalist, but I mean, yeah, definitely up there with the female vocalists that Cradle of Filth have had. And yeah, and it's always been one of my favorite things about Cradle of Filth is like that almost hauntingly, clean like female vocals mixed with Danny's harsh like screeches and just the chanting and all that sort of stuff, which they had plenty of in this CD, in this album. After that one was Discourse Between a Man and His Soul. Again, more Cradle of Filth. After so many years, like that's all I can really say about that band is they have a sound, and when the sound works, and when they get that sound, it's awesome. Some CDs have kind of fallen short of said sound that they are known for, and yeah. And then the last song on the second side, kind of rushing it a little bit. It looks like my battery's kind of dying on the camera, but the last song on the second side and the first actual record is The Dying of the Embers. And yeah, again, to me, just more good Cradle of Filth. This is obviously not going to be a very good review. It's Cradle of Filth. I have most of their stuff. I'm missing a few of their albums, but like I'm working on getting their whole discography for a reason. I like Cradle of Filth's music. I always have. And yeah, so the second LP, that record, whatever you want to call it, starts with Ash Immortality, which is the third and final instrumental. Not much to say. Very good song. I like their instrumentals. Not always the best, but it has that tendency to kind of give you like that feeling that like you're kind of, just it gives you a good mental image for the actual album itself, and it kind of breaks it up a little bit nicely so that you kind of don't just sort of tune everything out as the album progresses. How Many Tears to Nurture the Ro a Rose follows that short instrumental, and it's very fast-paced, very heavy. I liked it. Probably in my top five songs on the whole album. And yeah, I mean, probably top, I don't know, top 20 or so songs of Cradle of Filth's whole career. After that comes Suffer Our Dominion, which I don't know. I have this whole script and I'm not even like I'm paraphrasing most of it. You know, I had kind of troubles finding like cons to this album for the most part. Good, you know, they've had some weak albums in the past, and so it's always good when they come out with one that's just good all around. It doesn't come close to what I consider their golden duo, but we'll talk about that at the end of the video, after I give my score. But yeah, you know, this one has, you know, that typical Cradle of Filth, like, chanting, you know, throughout the song that breaks up the harsh screeches that Danny's got. And yeah, the last song on the standard edition of the album is Us Dark Invincible. It also ends the third side of the record. The fourth side has the two bonus tracks, which obviously we'll get into in a sec, but it definitely seemed to have like a nice catchy hook. Kind of draws you in well. It's a very solid end to the album itself if you get just the standard edition. Unfortunately, the CD copy that you saw me unbox is just the standard edition, which kind of sucks because I actually really, really dug the first of the two bonus tracks, Sisters of the Mist, which does start off the final side of the record, and it is definitely probably one of my favorite Cradle of Filth songs. It's probably my favorite song off this album. And it's making me kind of want to buy another actual CD, like the deluxe CD copy of the CD. I don't know if I'll do that or not. It would literally just be to get those two bonus songs onto my computer, which I may or may not do at some point. Who knows? But yeah, Sisters of the Mist kind of grips you. It's haunting. It's heavy. It's fast, it's slow, it's just a great song, in my opinion. Definitely check it out. I'm sure you can find it on YouTube somewhere. I will be linking in the description below the two music videos that they released. I'm pretty certain I can do that. I don't think that they would really care. It gives more people a chance to listen to them and find them. So, and the final song, and the final bonus song, the second one, is Unleash the Hellion, which, again, it's more Cradle of Filth. It's got that sound that, you know, Cradle of Filth fans, especially, you know, recent or even old Cradle of Filth fans, you know that sound that they have, and it's just more of the same. So yeah. I know it was rather short and sweet and whatnot, but, yeah, I give this album an 88 out of 100, not quite 90s, because I'm a bit biased. I got into Cradle of Filth back in Amphetamine, and I feel like, you know, nothing they kind of come out with anymore really kind of holds up to Midian and Amphetamine. Maybe even like Dusk and Her Embrace and, you know, that sort of stuff. But Midian and Amphetamine are probably still to this day my two favorite Cradle of Filth CDs. They're the two that I definitely always go back to when I just want that old school, you know, Cradle of Filth sound, that just nostalgia feeling. And I think that's part of it, is that it is nostalgia for me to go back and listen to the CDs that were out when I first got into the band. You know, I feel like it's like that for anybody who's a fan of any kind of music or any kind of band. is, you get so far into like the band's career and like you start listening to their newer stuff, and then every time you go back to the stuff that you first started listening to, even if it's not even their, best stuff out there, even if it's not their, grade A stuff, you get that nostalgia that is like, oh, this is what started it all for me. And I feel like that's part of it for me with Cradle of Filth. Bands like Demon Borgir are like that too. I love, Demon Borgir's latest stuff, even though I kind of do miss Vortex in that band. But, I go back to when, Silanoz was their vocalist, and it's just like, oh, but yeah, like Cradle of Filth is definitely going in the right direction with their last three albums now. They're getting back that sound that they did have back then, that they were known for. I feel like it kind of dropped off a little bit. I mean, yeah, you had the two concept albums and Manticore, which has like one or two good songs on it, in my opinion, and everything else on that CD was just kind of meh. But, I hope that Cradle continues on with this direction they're going in. Like, I definitely look forward to seeing what they come out with next. And other black metal-ish news, Demon Borgir, I did read recently, are in pre-production phase for a new CD. Talking about Demon earlier in the video, like a couple seconds ago, minute ago or two. So if you're into Demon, that's awesome. Definitely look forward to that because I'm going to be getting it, and I will review it, and I will probably have the same very biased review for that, unless I kind of get more comfortable doing this and actually kind of get a bit better at actually like expressing like my viewpoints of a song, of a band, of an album. This is only the second one I've done, so on camera I've done like one or two on like a forum I was on like a couple years ago, but yeah. And yeah, thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please comment if there's any kind of hints, like constructive criticism that you think you can give, throw my way. I'm always down for it. I love constructive criticism. It was even if it's just, to make me think about me, okay, maybe I should do these videos this way or that way or what have you. I said I wasn't gonna say it to every video, and I'm not gonna say it this video. If you watched my last video to the end, you know what I'm talking about. And I hope everyone has a great day. Have a happy Halloween if it's Halloween still when you see this, or else if I even get this up today, I don't even know. I recorded it. I'm recording it now, obviously, but I don't know if I'm actually going to get this video up today or if I'm just going to get it up at some point this week. But yeah, if I do get it up today, happy Halloween. If I don't get it up today, happy Halloween, since it's Halloween right now. And I hope you had a good Halloween or whatever. If you don't celebrate Halloween, so be it. Have a good day, and I will talk to everyone from this side of the camera, hopefully with my Thierfing album review, which will hopefully be coming up after this, because I have it. I have yet to listen to it, obviously. Well, probably not obviously, but it'll come. Hopefully shortly after this. I'll be off for a few days coming up, so I'll maybe be able to actually do some stuff for videos. And yeah. Bye.